next station stop?
You're crazy with the heat. Credit is no good to a notion salesman.
Board? Oh, board.
Why not? What's the matter with credit?
It's old-fashioned. Charlie, you're an anvil salesman. You're for a gift credit?
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
River City. River City next.
Cash for the merchandise. Cash for the button hooks.
Cash for the cotton goods. Cash for the hard goods. Cash for the soft goods.
Cash for the fancy goods.
Cash for the toggins and the piggins and the firkins.
Cash for the hog head cask and Debbie John. Cash for the crackers and the pickles and the flypaper.
What do you talk? But it's different than it was.
No, it ain't, but you gotta know the territory.
Shh, why, it's Mountain Ford made the trouble, made the people wanna get up and go. 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 22, 23 miles in the county seat.
Yes, sir.
Who's gonna patronize a little bitty 2x4 kind of store anymore?
What do you talk?
Where'd you get it? Not the Model T and all. Take a gander at the store. At the Modern store. At the present day store. At the present day Modern Departmentalized Grocery store.
What do you talk?
Where'd you get it?
What do you talk?
Where'd you get it?
You can talk, you can bicker. You can talk, bicker, you can talk all you want, but it's different than it was.
No, it ain't, but you got another territory.
Wes, you need a biscuit, Major Trouble. You need it. Put the crackers in the package. You need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package. Made the cracker barrel obsolete.
Cracker barrel went out the window with the mail patch, cup clock torn by the stove. Changed the approach of a traveling salesman, made it pretty hard.
No, it didn't, but you got another territory.
Go on.
Hogshead, cascade, demijohn. Gone with the cracker barrel, pickle barrel, milk pan. Gone with the tongue, the pan, the tears.
Ever meet a fella by the name of Hill?
Hill?
No!
Just a minute.
Never heard of any salesman, Hill. Now he doesn't know the territory.
What's a fella's line?
Never worry about his line.
Never worry about his line?
Or the cracker barrel being obsolete. Or the you need a biscuit in an airtight sanitary package. Or the Model T Ford.
Just a minute.
Never worry about his line. Or a doggone thing. He's just a bang, beat, bell, ringing, big hall, great go, never nothing, rip, roar, and every time a bullseye salesman. That's Professor Harold Dill.
Because what's his line? He's a fake, and he doesn't know the territory.
What do you talk? He's a music man.
He's a what?
He's a music man, and he sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums and the big brass bass, and the piccolo, the piccolo, the uniform, too, with the shiny braid on the coat and the big red stripe front.
Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones and rat-a-tat drums. No, sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, and here and there a Jew's harp.
No, the fella sells bands, boys' bands. I don't know how he does it. But he lives like a king, and he dallies, and he gathers, and he plucks, and he shines. And when the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. When the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir.
He doesn't know the territory.
Cross the state line into Iowa. Tobacco illegal in this state. Oh, boy.
Well, if you fellows are all done, I'll tell you about Harold Hill.
You really know Harold Hill?
Never saw him a day in my life, but I'll tell you this much. He's given every one of us a black eye. After he's worked the town over, the next salesman to arrive is automatically tarred and feathered and rode out to the city limits on a rail. You think it's funny? Wait till it happens to you. Your hair never grows back.
Well, why should he get rode out of town on a rail?
Because in order to sell band instruments and instruction books and uniforms, he's got to promise to teach them boys how to play.
So?
And to form them boys into a band with him as the leader.
Well, what's wrong with that?
He don't know one note from another. That's what's wrong with that. He don't know a bass drum from a pipe organ. I'll catch up to that swindling two-victim rigger. When I do, I'll squeal so loud you'll hear me.
Boy, you're really mad, Charlie. I sure like to be around when you catch up with that fella.
Not on this trip. Not in Iowa. Not even. even the great Professor Hill would try to sell them neck-bowed Hawkeyes out here.
Gentlemen, you intrigue me. I think I'll have to give Iowa a try.
Don't believe I caught your name.
Sunday, if you could accommodate me.
Then you ought to see the man in charge of hiring rigs. Who's late, as usual?
Henry!
Marcellus!
You old son of a gun!
In the way!
Harold Hill's the name. Harold Hill.
But Craig, what are you doing here? Why didn't you let me know you was coming?
I didn't know I was myself. Besides, how could I know you'd end up in a tank town like this? You're a pretty big slicker when you were in business with me.
Too many close shaves the way you work.
Besides, I got me a nice, comfortable girl. Ethel Poppelmacher, the boss's niece.
Gone legitimate, huh? I knew you'd come to no good.
So, what's the new pitch?
Oh, no, Greg, you're not back in the band business. I heard you was in steam automobiles.
I was.
But what happened?
Somebody actually invented one.
No.
Now, give me the lowdown here, Mars.
Well, you'll never get anywhere with these stubborn islands, Greg. Besides, we got a stuck-up music teacher who'll expose you the moment you get your grip unpacked.
Male or female?
The music teacher? Well, she's a librarian. Female.
Perfect. That's what I wanted to hear. When she passes by, you point her out to me.
I will. So how are you going to start the pitch?
Same old way. Just keep that music teacher off balance. Then my next step will be to get your town out of the serious trouble it's in.
But Greg, River City isn't in any trouble.
Then I'll have to create some. I have to create a desperate need for a boys band. You remember. Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Oh! Billiards parlor just put in a new pool table.
They never had a pool table before?
No, only billiards.
That'll do. See you later, Marks. And remember, music teacher.
Music teacher.
Either you're closing your eyes to a situation you do not wish to acknowledge, or you are unaware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a billiard player. Certainly mighty proud to say, I'm always mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help me cultivate a horse sense with a cool head and a keen eye. You ever take and try to give an ironclad leave to yourself from a three-rail billiard shop? But just as I say it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a ball-blind game, I say that any boob can take and shove a ball in a pocket. And I call that sloth the first big step on the road to the depths of degrade. I say first, medicinal wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in pinchback suits and listening to some big out-of-town Jasper hear him tell about horse race gambling. Not a wholesome trotting race, no, but a race where they sit down right on the horse. Like to see some stuck-up jaunty boy sitting on Dan Patch, make your blood boil? Well, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets in the table, pockets that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum, with a capital B, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for cool. And all week long, your River City youth will be frittering away, and say, your young men will be frittering. Frittering away their noontime, supper time, chore time too. Get the ball in the pocket, never mind getting dandelions full to the screen door attached to the beefsteak pounded. Never mind pumping any water till your parents are caught with a cistern empty on a Saturday night, and that's trouble. Yes, you got lots and lots of trouble. I'm thinking of the kids in the Knickerbocker, shirt-tailed young ones, speaking in the pool all winter after school. You got trouble, folks, right here in River City. Trouble with a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. Oh, I know all you folks are the right kind of parents. I'm going to be perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on while they're loafing around that hall? They'll be trying out Vivo, trying out Cubex, trying out TaylorMade's like cigarette fiends, and bragging all about how they're going to cover up a telltale breath with Sensen. One fine night, they leave the pool hall, heading for the dance at the armory. Libertine men and scarlet women and ragtime, shameless music elves, grab your son, your daughter, with the arms of the jungle, animal instinct, mass hysteria. Friends, the idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble! Right here in River City. With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. We surely got trouble. Right here in River City. Gotta figure out a way to keep our young ones moral after school. Mothers of River City, heed this warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee?
What church? Huh?
Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger?
Whippersnapper!
A dime novel hidden in the corn crib? Is he memorizing jokes out of Captain Billy's whiz-bang? Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like swell. And so's your old man. Well, if so, my friends, you got trouble. Right here in River City. With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. We surely got trouble. Right here in River City. Remember the Maine, Plymouth Rock, and the Golden Rule. Oh, we got trouble. We're in terrible, terrible trouble. That game with the 15-numbered balls is the devil's tool. Oh, yes, we got trouble, trouble, trouble.
Oh, yes, we got trouble here.
A short while.
Good.
That you, daughter?
Yes, Mama.
Just fixing the stairs. All is up. Keep on, Mama. I'll be there in a moment.
I don't remember the library being open last 4th of July.
It was, Mama, all evening.
Mama.
saw him before.
Did he see anything?
He tried.
Did you say anything?
Mom, of course not. Now don't dawdle, Amaryllis.
Sol, do, la, re, ti, mi. A little slower, and please keep the fingers curved as nice and high as you possibly can. Don't get faster, dear.
Well, if you don't mind my saying so, it wouldn't have hurt to find out what the gentleman wanted.
I know what the gentleman wanted.
What, dear?
You will find it in Balzac.
Well, excuse me for living, but I've never read it.
Neither has anyone else in this town.
There you go again with that same old comment about the low mentality of River City people and taking it all too much to heart.
Now, Mama, as long as Madison Public Library was entrusted to me for the purpose of improving River City's cultural level, I can't help my concern that the ladies of River City keep ignoring all my counsel and advice.
But, darling, when a woman has a husband and you have none, why should she take advice from you? Greeks.
Mama, if you don't mind my saying so, you have a bad habit of changing every subject.
Now I haven't changed the subject. I was talking about that stranger.
What stranger?
With the suitcase, who may be your very last chance.
Mama, do you think I'd allow a common masher? Now really, Mama, I have my standards where men are concerned, and I have no intention
of... I know all about your standards, and if you don't mind my saying so, there's not a man alive who could hope to measure up to that wonderful funny St. Patton or Webster. You can have it for yourself. Your library full of books.
Well, if that isn't the best I ever heard.
Thank you. Can I have a drink, please?
May I
have a drink,
yes,
please?
Yes, dear.
Oh. What kind of a way is that to walk into the house?
Hello.
That won't do at all. I'll have a kiss from my boy. And that lady over there is your sister, young man.
Hello, Winthrop.
Hello, Winthrop.
Winthrop, where are your manners?
Hello. I'm having a party on Saturday. I would especially like it very much if you'd come. Winthrop,
Amaryllis asked you to her party. Are you going or aren't you?
No.
No what?
No, thank you.
You know the little girl's name?
He won't say Amaryllis because of the S, because of his list. He's ashamed.
We know all about his list, Amaryllis.
I bet he won't say it. No, thank you, Amaryllis.
sure we're all grateful to my wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, for leading the singing. And to Ethel Koppelmeyer, our fine player, piano player, pianist. As mayor of River City, I welcome all you River citizens to the 4th of July exercises set up indoors here at the Madison Gymnasium on account of the rain. 47 members of the school board will now present a patriotic the members of the school board will not present a patriotic tableau. Some disagreement about costumes, I suppose. Instead, the Wat Tam Yi girls of the local wigwam of Hiawatha will present a spectacle, My Wife. In which my wife, Eulalie McKechnie Shin, will take a leading part.
John Philip Sousa,
all came to town on the very same historic day. 76 trombones led the big parade, with 110 cornets close at hand. They were followed by rows and rows of the finest virtuosos, the cream of every famous band. 76 trombones caught the morning sun, with 110 cornets right behind. There were more than 1,000 wreaths springing up like weeds. There were horns of every shape and kind. There were copper bottom timpani and horse platoon, thundering all along the way. Double bell euphoniums and big bassoons.
Excited since the night that Frank Gotch and Strangler Lewis laid on the mat for 3.5 hours without moving a muscle. Never mind. Get his credentials. Rabbi Hulam, he almost blew up Mrs. Shen.
Thank you, Professor. Got to make an example out of this kid. But he does his gang does.
Oh, great hop. Let me go.
You wild kid, you hanging around after my oldest girl. His father's one of the day workers south of town. He was tagging after my youngest girl last Sunday.
I wasn't either tagging.
Don't you counter.
We was just walking together.
Watch your phraseology. I know what she's doing. My little girl saw you hanging around my oldest girl. You stay away from her or you'll hear from me to who laid the rails. Hell, I'll talk to you Monday about this band thing. Over at City Hall, 10 o'clock sharp.
Men, I want that Spellbinder's credentials.
Constable, I'll be responsible for the boy.
You gotta be careful, Professor. He's a tough kid. His gang's waiting outside.
Oh, I'll be careful. Tommy, glad to talk to you about the band.
Oh, gee, Professor, that's for the little kids.
I'm not talking about playing in the band. You're mechanically minded, aren't you? Ever do anything with, perpetual motion?
Nearly had a couple times.
You did? You're my man. Do you realize nobody has invented a music holder for a marching piccolo player? There's no place to hang the music.
Great hunk. Wonder where I get some wire from.
Look in your cellar. That's where people keep wire. Oh, Tommy!
Yes, sir?
Now, Constable, I'll show you how to break up a gang. Oh, young lady. Oh, miss. What's your name?
Zanita. I had no idea you was beckoning to me. Good
job! Zanita, do you know Tommy Jewis?
No.
Tommy, this is Zanita. Escort the young lady home.
Only acceptance. I ain't going home. I got to go to the library. Good
job! Then escort the young lady home by way of the library. By way of the candy kitchen.
Yes, sir. Do I have to?
Oh, you have to.
Yes, sir.
You're a smart young fellow, Professor. Only made a couple of mistakes.
Oh?
Yeah, that billiard parlor and pool table belonged to the mayor.
What was my other mistake?
That girl you just sent off with Tommy Jewis? Mayor's oldest daughter.
Just a minute, Professor Hill. We'd like to have your credentials. We're the school board.
Academic certificates.
Nothing of the kind. We need letters and papers.
Make him put up a bond.
What am I hearing? Say,
ice cream. Ice cream, young man. I don't sing.
That's all right. Talk then. Down here.
Ice cream.
Talk slow.
Ice cream.
See? Singing is only sustained talking. Now you, sir. See one of these men without the other three.
Oh, Professor, you're wrong. Why, they've hated each other for 15 years.
Ice cream! Ice cream! Ice cream!
How can there be any
shame?
Conservatory man myself, Gary, Indiana, gold medal class of O5.
Even if that should happen to be true, does that give you the right to follow me around wherever I go? And another thing, Mr. Hill, I'm not as easily mesmerized or hoodwinked as some of the people in this town. And I think it only fair to warn you, I have a shelf full of reference books in there, which may very well give me some interesting information about you.
So, how'd you make out with that music teacher?
Scrumptious. Ate out of my hand the minute I tipped my hat.
She did. Boy, did you cut a swath tonight? For a minute there, even I thought you knew something about leading a band. Just like when you used to imitate that band concert fella back in Joplin, remember?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's kid stuff, Marsh. I'm in rare form these days. Just you keep your eyes on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? But it only used to take you 10 days for the instruments to arrive.
It still does. Only it takes 4 weeks for the uniforms.
Oh, no, Greg. You haven't added uniforms.
Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But you can't pass yourself off as a music professor. I mean, not for any 4 weeks.
Mars.
But you don't know one note from another.
I have a revolutionary new method called the Think System, but where you don't bother with notes.
In 4 weeks, the people are going to want to hear music. They're going to have to lead a band.
But when the uniforms arrive, they forget everything else. Just long enough for me to collect and leave. Oh, this is a refined operation, son. I've got it timed right down to the last wave of the brakeman's hand on the last train out of town. And now, if you'll excuse me.
Yeah. Go line yourself up for a little canoodle, huh?
Well,
Zach, let me fix you up with Ethel's sister, Myrtle Toppelmeyer. Lovely girl. She teaches Sunday school.
No wide-eyed, eager, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of gal spins web no spider ever. Now listen, son. A gal who trades on all that purity merely wants to trade my independence for her security. The only affirmative Sheila file refers to marching down the aisle. No golden, glorious, gleaming, pristine goddess. No, sir, for no Diana do I play on. I can tell you that right now. I snarl, I hiss. How can ignorance be compared to bliss?
I spark and I fizz for the lady who knows what time it is.
I cheer and I rave for the virtue I'm too late to say.
Child ties knots. No sailor ever knew. I prefer to take a chance on a more adult romance. No too young miss who keeps resisting. All the time she keeps insisting. No wide-eyed wholesome innocent female. No sir, why she's the fisherman, I'm the fish. You see, I flinch, I shy when the last with a delicate air goes by.
I smile and I grin when the gal with the touch of sin walks in.
I win just one more ray. The sadder but wiser girl's the girl for me. The sadder but wiser girl for me.
But you see, part of my music plans include a committee for the dance, and... Oh, wait. Wait, do that again, Mrs. Shin.
Do what? What did I do?
The way you raised your foot just now.
Oh, but yes, you see, I have a bunny in there, and it bothers
me. Oh, Grace! What natural flow of rhythm. What expression of line and movement.
Mr. Shin!
Oh, you must accept the chairmanship of the ladies' committee for the auxiliary dance, mustn't she?
Oh, yes, you must!
Every move you make, Mr. Shin, bespeaks Del Sar. Say you will. Will you?
Well, that is, I, well, you lady McKechnie Shin, that is,
dancing well.
Then you also,
oh, yes, indeed, I can.
Now,
young
lady who teaches piano, Marion Peru, I believe. After all, she is a librarian. Madison Picnic Park? Madison Hospital? That Miser Madison?
Exactly. Who do you think he was, anyway?
Oh, I should say. Show off. Gave the town the library, too, didn't he?
That's just it. When he died, he left the library building to the city.
But he gave all the books to her.
Oh, yes. She was seen going and coming and coming and going from his place.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That woman made brave overtures. With a gilt-edged guarantee. She would go from glen to glen and fill the voice for the counterfeit ring. Just melt her down and you'll reveal it. Look, she led us all to steal here, where woman's heart should be.
He left River City, the library building, but he left all the books to her.
Chaucer,
Dabblings,
Walls,
explanations. I'll only be in town a short while, and the sadder but wiser girl for me.
Will you please make your selection and leave?
I have.
Well, what's yours to take out?
The librarian.
Shh! Quiet, please.
The librarian. You're not listening, Marion. Look. Marion. Marbles. Six Sealies, eight Aggies, a dozen Pee-wees, and one big glassy with an American flag in the middle. I think I'll drop them.
No!
Shh! Madam Librarian. Rhea. What could I do, my dear, to catch your ear? I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian. Marry me, heaven help us, if the library's caught on fire. And the volunteer hose brigade had to whisper the news to Mary. Rhea. Madam Librarian. Rhea. What could I say, my dear, to make it clear? I need you badly, badly, Madam Librarian. Marion, if I stumble and I busted my watch, whatchamacallit, I could lie on your floor unnoticed till my body had turned to cat. Rhea. Madam Librarian. Rhea. Now in the moonlight, a man could sing it. In the moonlight, and a fellow would know that his darling had heard every word of his song. With the moonlight helping him along. But when I try in here to catch your ear, I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian. Marion, it's a long lost cause I can never win. For the civilized world accepts as unforgivable sin any talking out loud with any librarian, such as Marion. Madam Librarian. dance meeting in Tuesday night at the high school.
Would you just come in?
Ray.
Marshmallow.
Bell and Lively.
Just a minute here. Are you soliciting? You don't have a license.
Why, no, Mayor Shin. I collect doorbells. And this particular specimen has an unusual tone quality that I have not come across.
Flattery will not avail you. Soliciting is statutory in this county. Malfeasance without a permit.
Mayor Shin, your hand. Oh, no. That spread of the little finger? That's hereditary.
It is? What does that mean?
It means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate the spit valve on a B-flat flugelhorn.
Is that good?
Good! It means that America has at last produced an artist who can flugel the minute waltz in 50 seconds.
How can I get one of those horns?
Sign here, Mayor Shin. That'll be $17 import fee.
Yes, sir. Just think, I might have missed out on this whole... I don't have a son. Why, you unscrupulous! Flew by night, I'm flipless. You'll be down to City Hall with your by-God papers at 3 o'clock.
You mean this afternoon?
I couldn't make myself any plainer if I was a Quaker on his day off.
Mrs. Peru, do you realize we have the facial characteristics of a cornet virtuoso?
Well, I don't know if I understand you entirely, Professor.
Why, if your boy has that same firm chin and those splendid cheek muscles, by George! Not that he could ever be really great, you understand.
Oh, is that so? And in the name of St. Bridget, why not?
Well, you see, all the really great cornet players were Irish. O'Clark, O'Mendez, O'Kline.
But, Professor, we are Irish.
No.
We are Peru's Irish.
No, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that clinches it, Mrs. Peru. Sign here. Your boy was born to play the cornet. That'll be $7 earnest money. Nothing more due until the first installment, payable at the opening of band practice.
Very good. Here you are, Professor.
And of course, I'll need the boy's measurements for his uniform.
His uniform? Oh,
hello, son. Why, certainly his uniform. And there won't be a penny due until the opening of band practice, which gives him 4 weeks to enjoy, to anticipate, to imagine. Never put off until tomorrow. But never let the demands of tomorrow interfere with the joys and excitement of today.
Would he have a...
A stripe? Certainly, my boy. A wide red stripe down each side. What do you think of that?
You'll have to excuse Winthrop, Professor. We can't get him to say 3 words a day, even to us. And if you can get him to join the band, well, you'll have St. Michael's own way with you. But I think if anyone can do it, you can. Out of a crowd, I pick you for hog-carrying, clay-pipe-smoking, shamrock-wearing, harp-playing, maubreen-pinching, Tara's Hall minstrel Irishman, big gob and big jabbers, where you from, me boy?
Gary, Indiana.
Yeah, I knew it. Where did you say?
Gary, Indiana.
What a wonderful name.
Named for Elbert Gary, of judiciary fame. Gary, Indiana, as Shakespeare would say, trips along softly on the tongue this way. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, let me say it once again. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, that's the town of New Wren. If you'd like to have a logical explanation how I came upon this elegant syncopation, I can say without a moment of hesitation, there is just one place that can light my face. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, not Louisiana, Paris, France, New York, or Rome, but Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, my home sweet home.
Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana.
course, Peru. I thought the name sounded familiar.
Marion, the professor wants to put Winthrop in the band.
We're not interested, Mom.
But Marion, the boy might have his father's musical gift. He does have my jawline, you know.
Oh, your husband musical? I'd like to have a talk.
Do you person in everyone's homes like this, prying into personal affairs? We're not interested.
Marion!
Well, that's one for and one against. Why not let the boy's father decide?
The boy's father is dead. Anything else?
Oh, I am sorry. But that's all the more reason your brother should have something like...
My brother is a 10-year-old problem child who can't understand why his father was taken away. Would you care to explain it to him? He's been brooding about it for over 2 years. And as for your musical tricks, why don't you go into business with some nice carnival man who sells gold-painted watches and glass diamond rings?
Musical tricks? Miss Peru, I hardly think... I get the feeling she likes the idea. Oh, a little cautious, perhaps, but I admire that in a woman. Just keep me alive, and I'll be back later in the week.
Professor, about Winthrop's uniform, I made all of his clothes. I'll give you his measurements. His sleeve is 21, waist 18, crotch 14.
Ah, thank you. Now I must get back to the hotel.
Professor, please excuse Marion. She's truly a darling girl.
Oh, please, don't worry about a thing. I'm sure that at heart, she's as lovely as yourself.
Oh, Professor.
Good day to you, Winifaroo.
Good day, Professor Hill. Oh, has he gone?
Oh, he has. And I hope not forever. Darling, do you ever think about your future?
Dowry Conservatory, class of 05. Mama, surely a girl's future doesn't depend on encouraging every self-centered, woman-chasing travel man who comes to town. And the fact that he claims his commodity is music does not, in this particular case, impress me.
Fine, dear, fine. But it's a well-known philosophy that if you keep the steel in one drawer and the flint in the other, you're never gonna strike much of a fire.
Mama. Winthrop, Winthrop, I know you're there. Can you go to the library and ask Mrs. Grubb for the book I set aside? It's the Indiana State Education Journal. It's a large blue volume with black corners.
Do I have to?
You don't have to talk to anyone. I've written it all down.
Thank you.
Now what are you up to, ordering books at this hour of the night?
I have a feeling that that Indiana State Journal may help me poke some larger holes into the professor's claims.
Suit yourself, dear. But at your age, I don't know what kind of white knight you'll think is going to come riding along.
I'm certainly not waiting for Luther Griner, who backs me into the ancient history shelf every time he comes into the library.
He does!
Or Ed Gammons in that buggy of his with the removable back seat. But I'm not waiting for a knight in shining white armor, either.
My white knight, not a Lancelot, nor an angel with wings, just someone to love me, who is not ashamed of a few nice things. My white knight, what my heart would say if it only knew how. Please, dear Venus, show me how.
yard, and now the footprint. And where are we going to meet after that? In the black hole of Calcutta? Ye gods!
I'm going to show you my invention.
What invention?
A music holder for a marching piccolo player. It still has a couple minor flaws. See, when you keep it tight enough to hold the music steady, you cut off the circulation and you can't wiggle your fingers. Meanwhile, you could go blind.
Tommy, it's Papa!
Is that the first thing I said or not?
Yes, George.
Yes, the very first thing I said, or I'll eat hay with the horse. I said, get that spellbinder's credentials on the morning of July 4th, 1912. And now look, my wife is off dancing at any and all hours instead of being in the home. And the school board is singing up streets and down alleys instead of taking care of city matters. And my oldest girl is boodling around with some wild kid. And my business has fallen off so far, I can't even find the balance sheet.
Mayor Shin, I found something interesting in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
His who?
His university.
Oh, I know all about that. In fact, that's the only thing I can ever get out of it. Gary Conservatory, class of '05.
If you just take a little bit to read a bit about the university, you won't have to look far. It's right on this page.
Papa, Papa, the Wells Fargo wagon is coming from the depot.
Nonsense, on a Saturday night, the Wells Fargo wagon?
But it could be the band instruments.
The band instruments? From the librarian.
Gentlemen, you'll each receive individual instructions in due course. In the meantime, stay off the streets, get familiar with your instruments, and think about the minuet in G. La di da di da di da di da, la di da, la di da, la di da. Kids Dance Committee meets Tuesday nights at the high school.
And now, Mrs. Shin and the Delsart Ensemble will rehearse their dance.
Oh, come on, Mr. Washburn. Let's do the new dance Professor Hill taught us.
Mr. Washburn, we are entitled to 5 more minutes.
Ladies, the floor is all yours.
Lovely, ladies, lovely. Now turn. Take the body with you, Shirley. Take the body with you. Lovely. All right. Now let's do our stretching, shall we, ladies? Bend and stretch and rise. Oh, lovely. Let's have a go at our Grecian urn, shall we? 1 Grecian urn. 2 Grecian urns. Oh, 3 Grecian urns. Oh, lovely, ladies, lovely. Now let us practice our movement. Moving, floating like a cloud. Oh, Charlie! Shirley, Shirley, take the body with you, remember. Take the body with you. Oh, let's try it once more, ladies. Move.